pick the specialty that best matches their personality. Because everybody likes emergency medicine, and that's one thing, but doing it for the rest of your life is quite a different thing, and they need to sort that out. What's good for a month may not be good for a lifetime. Patience and persistence. I'm like, I'm an emergency physician. That doesn't fit. He said, no, really, you need patience and persistence to get things done. And of course, he was right. The level of persistence you needed, though, was way beyond rationality, I thought. Still think.
It's a great specialty. The best thing about it is whether you can survive and thrive in an environment which is chaotic to other people, but has got so many things going on, which you'll never be on top of. You'll always be learning, and you'll be working within a really wide group of patients and staff. So if you're a social person who likes complexity, uncertainty, and decision-making, and some days doing amazing things, come on down, see if you love it.
What advice would you like to have been given when you were starting your career in emergency medicine?
When I started, it was just like, go work. The best advice would have been a little bit of looking after yourself and physician wellness, which was an unknown entity back in my day, but now it's very important that doctors look after themselves so that they can better look after their patients.
I started in the UK, it was very, very busy at the time, and I think it would have been around how to look after yourself well and maintain your health and your fitness to enable you to do your job better and look after yourself. Yeah.
I think we're doing a lot better now about understanding how important it is to look after our own personal health and to take time to stay fit, to stay healthy. And I think I would have benefited from more of a lesson around that, and not necessarily focusing just on a career in my early days, but making sure that I stay fit and healthy as a person.
I probably think, I must admit, probably looking after myself a little bit more. I think it was a challenging 4 years that we had in South Africa, and probably understanding the impact that a little bit about that work-life balance. I probably was a little bit more work-focused, and I might have changed that if I had the opportunity to go back again.
I would say find a hobby and pursue that hobby just as passionately as you pursue medicine.
If you enjoy emergency medicine or any career, go for it, love it, and blend it with your life. This whole idea about work-life balance, they're separate, they're not. We spend so much time at work that you have to enjoy what you do.